Today we are making lemon blueberry sweet rolls. It's a cinnamon roll dough that's from scratch, but instead of cinnamon, we're adding lemon and blueberries in the middle. You're not gonna wanna miss it. Hey everyone, it's Dorothy with crazyforcrust.com and welcome back to my kitchen. I'm showing you how to make one of the most popular cinnamon roll recipes on my site. It's actually a sweet roll because there's no cinnamon in it. There's tons of lemon in the dough and in the filling, and we're also using blueberries, and then it's a lemon icing on top. Oh, these are so delicious. For more desserts and easy recipes, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Now let's get in the kitchen. This dough starts off with a homemade, sweet, soft dough, and it's gonna be a yeasted dough. I promise it's easy to make. So I'm gonna start with 2/3 of a cup of milk. I'm using non-fat, but you can use regular or non-fat or non-dairy. And I'm gonna heat that in the microwave until it's, you can think hot bath water if you don't have an instant read thermometer, but it wants to be around 110 degrees for it to activate the yeast. And then we're gonna add 1 packet or 2¼ teaspoons of active dry yeast, along with 1/2 teaspoon of sugar into that measuring cup. And then you're gonna just stir it and let it sit until that yeast is nice and bubbly and activated. If it doesn't start to get bubbly and yeasty smelling and it doesn't seem to activate, that means that something is wrong with your yeast, or so you might want to try it with a different packet. I'm going to add 1/3 cup of granulated sugar, along with 3 tablespoons of softened unsalted butter, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 large egg, 1 teaspoon of lemon zest, and 2 tablespoons of fresh lemon juice into the bowl of my stand mixer. You're gonna mix that until the butter is distributed throughout the liquids. It's gonna be chunky and not completely mixed, that's okay. Once your yeast mixture has activated, add that into the butter mixture in the stand mixer. Once that is combined, you're gonna add 3 cups of all-purpose flour in here. I am using all-purpose flour because it's just simple. It's what I already have. I don't have to buy anything special. I love using all-purpose flour. Make sure to measure it correctly. And you're gonna mix that together and mix it on low until it kind of comes together and that flour incorporates in and it's not flying everywhere. And then turn it up to medium speed and mix with the dough hook until the dough forms a ball in the center of the mixer. It'll kind of knead it for you so you don't have to knead it. And once your dough is all combined, it pulls away from the sides of the bowl as it's kneading, and that's how you know that it's done. If it's still super wet after you've incorporated it, you can add about 1/4 cup of flour, but start with it 1 tablespoon at a time. You don't wanna add too much. The dough's gonna be slightly sticky and elastic. If you touch it, there'll be minimal transfer to your finger. Now with active dry yeast, there's two rises with active dry yeast. So I'm gonna spray a large bowl with nonstick cooking spray and add the dough. And then I'm gonna spray the top of it with more nonstick cooking spray and cover it tightly with plastic wrap. That's so that the dough doesn't stick to the plastic wrap. That's why I spray it with nonstick spray. You're gonna let this sit for about 2 to 4 hours until it doubles in size. Now, if you're making this, if it's winter, if it's cold in your house, it might take longer. You can speed up this process by doing it in the oven. I like doing that. What you do to make the dough rise faster in the oven is preheat your oven to 200 degrees, which is the lowest setting, and then just let it run for 15 minutes, turn it off, and then put that bowl in the oven, covered with the plastic wrap, and just let it sit. And probably within an hour, it will be nice and doubled in size. All right, so now while our dough is rising, we need to make the filling. Add 4 tablespoons of softened unsalted butter with 1/2 cup of granulated sugar, 2 teaspoons of lemon zest, 2 tablespoons of all-purpose flour, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt into a medium-sized bowl. And you're just gonna stir that together as long as your butter is soft enough. That's why I like to make sure that it's very soft. You can just stir it together, otherwise you can use a hand mixer. It's gonna be a thick paste when this all comes together. And now once our dough is risen and we have our filling, it is time to assemble our sweet rolls. So I'm gonna turn my risen dough out onto a floured surface. I'm using a cutting board here. Just turn it out onto a lightly floured surface and flour your rolling pin. Don't use too much flour because you don't wanna add a ton of excess, but you just don't want anything to stick. And you're just gonna roll this into a large rectangle, about 10 by 15 inches. you're going to spread the filling all over the center. Now, it's a very thick filling. It's not gonna spread super easily, so you can kind of like sprinkle it, kind of like work it with your fingers or an offset spatula. Just kind of make sure it goes all the way to the edges in a nice thin layer. And that's when I'm gonna add the blueberries. So I'm gonna add about 2 cups of blueberries. Now you can use fresh, you can use frozen, you can use canned. If you're using frozen, make sure they're completely thawed and drained. If you're using canned, make sure that they're completely drained. I'm using fresh today. I also love using the mini wild blueberries in this. It's great for little bits of blueberry in every bite instead of big chunks of blueberry. Use your favorite. You're gonna spread the blueberries evenly over that filling, and then we're gonna roll it up from the long side. Roll it as tight as possible. Now, once it's rolled up, it's time to slice the rolls. Now you can use a serrated knife, but I find the easiest way to cut cinnamon rolls is using unflavored dental floss. Now, I highly recommend just buying a box of unflavored and leaving it in your kitchen. You don't wanna make your rolls taste minty. So just use unflavored dental floss, wrap it, put it underneath the roll, and then pull it through, and it slices it super simple and it won't collapse on itself. You're gonna divide this into 12 rolls, which you're going to add to a 9x13 pan that I've sprayed with nonstick cooking spray. And now you have to let these rise again for about another hour or so. They'll get nice and puffy, not quite doubled in size. What I like to do is just preheat my oven at this point and place them on my oven, just sitting on top of the stovetop, so that the heat from the oven as it's preheating will help them rise a little bit faster. You can also use that oven trick for rising that I did before, or you can make these ahead of time. Cover them with plastic wrap and put them in the refrigerator. They'll rise really, really slowly. You can do it the night before and then just let them sit out while the oven's preheating to come up to room temperature. Once they are risen for the second time, you're gonna bake these at 350 degrees for about 18 to 25 minutes until they're nice and lightly golden and cooked through the center. While they're baking, we're going to make the frosting. Now this is a cream cheese frosting with lemon juice. It's super tart and sweet. I like using really, really soft cream cheese. I'll even heat it in the microwave to get it nice and soft so I can just use a whisk to make this. But you could also use a hand mixer or a stand mixer to make it. But to make the frosting, you're gonna mix 2 tablespoons of melted butter with 2 ounces of very soft cream cheese with 1.5 cups of powdered sugar, a pinch of salt, and 3 to 4 teaspoons or maybe a little bit more depending on how soft your cream cheese is. You might need a little bit more or a little bit less lemon juice. That gives a nice lemon flavor to this. I like to have the consistency that's a little bit pourable instead of having to spread it. If your cream cheese isn't quite soft enough, it's gonna be more of a like an icing that you would spread like a frosting. If it's really soft enough and you're able to do it with a whisk, it's gonna be more pourable. And then once the hot rolls come out of the oven, go ahead and spread that frosting all over the top and serve them. These are soft and pillowy. You can tell how soft that dough is, and it's sweet, and there's lemon in every bite because there's lemon in the dough and in the filling and in that frosting, and the burst of the blueberries, they kind of start to burst a little bit when they're cooking in the oven. These are so good. If you love lemon, blueberry, anything, these will become your absolute favorite. Leave me a comment and let me know what your favorite lemon blueberry treats are, and keep watching for even more breakfast recipes.